32 different composite modes. That is the number the Resolve lets you choose from, but how should you know which one to use and when? Have you ever looked at all the different composite modes in Resolve and all you ended up with was a big question mark in your head? Let me try to help you understand them just a little bit better. So the next time you want to use them, you know exactly which one to choose without having to wait for the preview to load in your viewer. But first of all, we gotta clarify the term composite or blend mode. A composite or blend mode takes the pixels of one layer and blends them with the pixels of another layer to create a completely new effect depending on the composite mode that you've chosen. Blend or composite modes allow you to do so much more than just adjusting the opacity. They allow you to blend layers based on their luminance value, hue, and or saturation. And now instead of explaining each of those modes individually, which would, let's be honest, bore you to death, let's just simplify it and put them into different groups. And the groups we're talking about are Normal, Darken, Lighten, Contrast, Inversion, and Component. In the first group, which is Normal, we only have one option, and that is Normal. And this blend mode or composite mode produces no change. And you can only blend them with the layer below by reducing the opacity. The next group is Darken, and these composite modes make the resulting blend darker. In this group, you will find the composite modes Multiply, Color Burn, Linear Burn, and Darker Color. When I apply the Multiply composite mode, notice how the image gets progressively darker towards the left side where black was, and towards the right side where white was, it becomes more and more transparent. And that is because we perform a darken operation. Now the next group of composite modes is Lighten, and these composite modes do the exact opposite of what the darken group does. In this group, you will find the composite modes Screen, Color Dodge, Linear Dodge, and Lighter Color. And these composite modes will make the resulting blend brighter. In this example, where I apply the screen composite mode, notice how the image gets progressively brighter towards the right side where white was, and towards the left side where black was, it becomes more and more transparent. And that is because we perform a lighten operation. The contrast blend modes, however, they just work a little bit differently. First of all, they will check whether a pixel is brighter than 50% gray or darker than 50% gray. And if a pixel is brighter than 50% gray, it will perform a lighten operation. If a pixel is darker than 50% gray, however, it will perform a darken operation. These composite modes accept hard mix. They will turn 50% gray transparent. In this group, you will find the composite modes Overlay, Soft Light, Hard Light, Vivid Light, Linear Light, Pin Light, and Hard Mix. Notice when I apply the Overlay composite mode towards the left side where black was, the image becomes progressively darker, and towards the right side where white was, the image becomes progressively brighter. However, in the middle where 50% gray was, the image becomes transparent. And that is because we've used the contrast operation mode. So the next group that we're going to talk about is Inversion. And these composite modes, they look for variations between the blend layer and the base layer to create the blend. In this group, you will find the composite modes Difference, Exclusion, Subtract, and Divide. A good example here is Difference. If I duplicate my base layer and on the blend layer, I change the composite mode to Difference, the image turns black. And that is because there is no difference. But if I change the position X and Y on the blend layer, you can see the difference. The results in this group are kind of extreme and therefore they aren't used very often. Last but not least, we have the component group. And these composite modes use different combinations of the primary color components, hue, saturation, and luminance to create the blend. In this group, you will find the composite modes hue, color, luminosity, and saturation. So this is probably the easiest group to understand. If you select a composite mode from this group, it will only affect that specific component and not the others. So in this case, if you select luminosity, it will only affect the luminance values and not the hue, color, and saturation. However, if you select saturation, it will only affect the saturation values and not the luminosity, hue, and color. So if you have any questions left, feel free to ask them in a comment section below this video. Otherwise, I'm gonna wrap this up for today. Hope you're having an amazing day. I'm gonna see you next week. Bye.